my lord, you are kidding me. Hi guys, welcome back to my I just hit myself in the face. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My leg is really itchy. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be doing a full face of makeup that I never use. So all of these products are either stuff that I just find doesn't work as well for me, or it's stuff I've impulse bought and I've tried it and been like, oh, that's cute, and then it goes to the back of my drawer. I thought I'd like challenge myself by delving into this stuff that I never go for. I wanted to see if maybe there's some products that I haven't been using which are actually like magical. I'm pretty sure most of this is drugstore as well, actually. Like maybe 99% drugstore. So my setup's gonna be a little bit different for a while because my ring light broke. Okay, it didn't break. The bit that connects my camera broke off and my camera dropped on the ground. And I literally thought that like my YouTube was over and I was crying and my mum came in and was like, why are you crying? And I was like, my camera's gonna be broken and I can't upload my video. And then I just put my battery back in my camera and it was fine. Basically, we're gonna be having on the floor videos because I have to put my camera on my tripod now and my tripod is like this tall. So we're just gonna have to put up with that for a while until I can afford to get either a better ring light or a better tripod. But I feel like the floor isn't so bad. Like I set up this curtain behind me, looking pretty cute. Oh my God, that fly. Where does it go? It's here and then it's not here. You know what's ridiculous? In America, I feel like a lot of places don't have fly screens on their windows. Cause whenever you see the movies, like the teenagers just open the window and crawl out. If you tried doing that here, like you'd have to take out the entire fly screen to actually get out the window. Also, I just checked my subscribers and I have 600. Last time I checked, I literally had like under 100. So I was gonna do a video for 100 subscribers, but I feel like I should wait until 1,000 now. I wanna do something really special for 1,000 subscribers. So if you guys have any ideas, just let me know down below in the comments. Oh my God. Thank you so much for 8,000 views on my price challenge video. I checked it yesterday and it was like 4,000 and today it's 8,000 and it's just, oh, there's so many people commenting. This girl from Chile messaged me and like told me that she watched my video and it's literally the most bizarre thing ever. Like, thank you so much. I had no idea that that video was gonna do so well. Okay, so I'm gonna get into the video or else I'm gonna be talking for way too long. As per usual, I'm gonna start with my brows. Usually with my brows, I go for either my Benefit Precisely My Brow or my Anastasia Dip Brow. But before I had either of those, I used to use this bad boy. So this is the NYX Tame and Frame in Brunette. Now, I think the only reason I stopped using this is because I left it open and it dried out. So I added coconut oil to this, but I feel like it never really went back to its true formula. I haven't used it in ages. It's just been sitting at the back of my drawer. I'm just gonna fill in my brows as per usual and see how this goes. Using my trusty Jeffree Star mirror. I feel like the drugstore has really upped its game, especially when it comes to eyebrows, eyeshadows, and stuff like that. Like, you could always find good mascaras at the drugstore and good foundations, but recently they've really, really been making high quality stuff. I've noticed more and more younger people in beauty going for more high-end products rather than drugstore. Living in Australia, when I first started out makeup, it was really hard for me to get high-end products. Like, we had no brands until recently. Kind of makes you realize how much you can put drugstore products into good use. There is still heaps of drugstore products that I prefer over high-end makeup. I feel like most brands have brought out brow pomades now. This is the only drugstore one I've tried so far. If you guys do have any good recommendations for dupes though, can you like say it down in the comments? Cause I'd love to know, and I'm sure there's heaps of people who would love to know as well. Cause makeup is expensive, especially in Australia, so expensive. When it comes to brow gels, I don't really have anything drugstore that I never use cause the only thing I ever really use is the Astralis Extender Brow, I'm pretty sure it's called. But something I do have that's cheap, actually free, is a sample of the Benefit Gimme Brow.
See ya.
Is a sample of the Benefit Gimme Brow Plus. Now this is just a little tinted brow gel. Fun fact, I used to work at Benefit. Samples are something that I didn't know about till recently, but oh, I love them. You can go into Sephora or Mecca and you can ask for a sample of anything you want. Like, as long as they can put it into a pot, you can ask for a sample of it. And I think that's amazing because that's free makeup. I should be on extreme cheapskates. So that's the Gimme Brow. I actually do really like the Gimme Brow though. I have had the full size one. I feel like brows is something that Benefit just does amazingly. Like all of their brow products, the color range and everything is just great. Moving on to concealer. Normally for concealer, I just go for your doe-footed applicator type thing like this, just so you can dot it on. Something I tend to stay away from is pot concealers. I just find it a little bit more difficult because you kind of have to stick your finger in or stick your brush in. One that I really haven't actually tried that much is actually another NYX product. It's the NYX Above and Beyond Full Coverage Concealer in beige. And yeah, I haven't touched this one that much. I just find it a little bit more convenient normally to go in with a doe-footed applicator. I'm gonna use this to prime my lids and also to cut out my brows. I actually tried filming this video before and my house was just way too noisy. Like, I have a lot of pets and it's much better to film at night time when they're all asleep. I actually really don't mind the way this is cutting out my brows right now. I'd normally go for a bit of a lighter concealer to prime my lids, but this shouldn't be too bad. I feel like the trick with this concealer is don't blend it in too much, just kind of tap it into the skin. See what I mean though? It gets onto your nails. Having a pot like this, that's the only thing that turns me off. So I don't actually have many palettes that I never reach for, I found. I kind of cycle through all of my palettes, but the only one that I hadn't touched in a hot minute was this. So this is the Astralis Kaleidoscope palette. The reason I haven't really touched this, other than that yellow shade here, is the fact that all of the shades are actually shiny and I thought they were matte when I bought it. But you know what? Today we're gonna give it a go. So I'm thinking I'm gonna do like a sunset eye type of thing. Now I remember the yellow in here being really pigmented, so I'm hoping the other colors live up to that expectation. I've only used this like twice, maybe once. The thing is, it looked shiny on top, but now that I'm like dipping in, it looks matte. So I'm really confused. Maybe it just has a shiny coat on the top. Anyway, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start the sunset with this yellow. Now I've already used this a couple times. It's actually a pretty good yellow. I'd say it's comparable to like my Morphe 35B and just put that in the crease. I remember when Instagram was having like their yellow makeup moment. And that's why I bought this palette, just for the yellow. This is the only Astralis palette I have, but I'm pretty sure Astralis have some other really good palettes as well. Like, Astralis products are bomb. Anybody who doesn't live in Australia and you don't get Astralis, unlucky, because it is really affordable and really good. It blended out really smoothly. And as you can see, it's really vibrant as well. Just gonna take this little Zoeva brush and this red color here, and I'm just gonna put that right below the yellow. Speaking of eyeshadow palettes, I'm gonna order the P. Louise palette soon, which I'm so excited for. The Secret Sinner, I think it's cool. I'm also really considering getting the Huda Beauty Nudes palette. Michael Finch reviewed it, and apparently it's much higher quality than her last palettes. And everyone uses it on Instagram, everyone. And those glitters look like so pretty. I feel like I need to start using some new products in videos and those would be some really fun ones to use. This look is giving me like Macca's vibes. I do not understand why other countries don't call it Macca's. Saying McDonald's is just so time consuming. These are blending together so bomb. I don't know what you guys are seeing, but I am seeing blended perfection right now. I'm going to take this end orange color. I don't really know what this is supposed to be. It's kind of like
orangey, reddish, pink. Somewhere in between there. I'm gonna put it in the middle of those two colors just to blend everything a little bit more. Finally, I'm gonna go in with this purple shade down here. Now dipping into this, yeah, this one's shimmery. And I'm just gonna take that on my finger and pat it all over the lid. As you can see, I have like hardly any fallout under my eyes, but just to clean up the little bit of fallout I do have, I'm gonna grab a wipe and just... These are also drugstore wipes, $2 from Priceline. They're the Beauty Essentials Fresh Micellar Cleansing Wipes. I think I'm gonna do like my straight edge today. Now we are not done with the eyes yet. I'm actually gonna go in with another Astralis product. This is actually already looking really cute. A while ago, I got a few of these Astralis Metal AF eyeshadow, liquid eyeshadows. This one is in Amethyst. I don't know why I haven't used these because they're actually really gorgeous. This one's like an iridescent kind of purple. And it actually has like some green reflex in it, which is really pretty. And I feel like this is gonna look beautiful on top of the purple. Just popping it in the middle of my lid. And these are so shiny and gorgeous. Maybe I should do a full face of Astralis. So pretty. That's it for the top of the eyes. Now I got this little Nude by Nature kit for Christmas and it came with the Allure Defining Mascara in black. Now typically my go-to mascara is actually the Maybelline Full and Soft. That has been my favorite since I was 14 years old and I'm 19 now. Usually I go for a brush mascara rather than a plastic one. These plastic ones are great, but oh my god, the second you touch your eye, it feels like you're slicing it open. Like, they are dangerous. Okay, that's done for the eyes so far. I'm just gonna apply some lashes. I don't have any that I don't grab, so I'm just gonna apply some random ones and I will be right back. Mwah. Lashes are on. These ones are from Wish. You can find some crazy good lashes on Wish. Just look at the reviews and usually people have photos of the lashes on them. Now that the eyes are completely done and I'm super duper happy with them, we're gonna go on to the face. So, to start off with, this primer I've probably touched once. I can't even remember when I got it, so I was for sure out of date. Yeah, 12 months after opening and I'm pretty sure I got it a good 3 years ago. Anyway, it's called the Revlon Photo Ready Perfecting Primer. It's thick. Okay, I feel like it's like a mattifying primer. It's also dried up a little bit. It reminds me of the Benefit Professional, so in that case, I'm just gonna apply it just around my nose like I would do with the Professional. I'll see how it looks. Oh, it looks matte in the viewfinder. That is actually giving a really similar effect to the Benefit Professional. That looks really good so far, but I'm not gonna speak too soon. This is scary for me, this part, because I really like a dewy foundation. I'm gonna be using the L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Matte. I remember this being good coverage, but I remember when I used it, I had a lot drier skin and it would cling to my dry patches a little bit. But you know what? I was worse at makeup back then and I'm better now, so we're gonna see how it looks today. I think this might be a bit dark for me. I'm gonna take the color Sand. I don't know why I bought two colors in this. I do not remember why I bought two colors because I didn't even use it that much. I must have been like, I want my summer color and my winter color. And both of them are too dark for me. Surprisingly, this shade actually looks too light. So we're gonna go in with Golden Beige. I'm feeling like I wanna be a full coverage queen today, so I'm just gonna pack this on. Now I'm just patting this in. And it's actually looking pretty good so far. A bit heavier than I typically wear my foundation. I'm just gonna add a little bit more. I think this would be very good for clubbing. I might actually start using it if I go out, which I probably won't because that's too much effort. But look how matte that is. and really full coverage. I actually really like the way this is looking. I didn't even realize that this would match me right now. Like, I got out my foundation mixer because I thought it would be too dark, but
your girl is tan at the moment.
I feel caked, but like in the best way possible.
I'm living. I'm gonna charge my battery because it's literally gonna die in 2 seconds and I will be right back. Words cannot even begin to explain how much I need a second battery.
Oh my God, that was so annoying. Let's get back into the video. Foundation is on and I am absolutely snatched right now. Who knew that I would be living for matte? Like, so I'm not gonna use a pot concealer this time because I think the one I used on the eyes is just a little too dark to do under. I'm gonna use my LA Girl Pro Conceal. I got this in light ivory and it is for sure not light ivory. It's just very yellow and that's why I haven't used it. Compared to my foundation, yes, this seems light. I purchased this when I was very, very pale in winter and it was too dark for my under eyes, so I haven't touched it since. I can't even remember what I think about the formula because I haven't touched it in a while, but we're gonna find out now. I remember it being really full coverage. I feel like I'm actually gonna really like this now. This was so popular on Instagram, like, oh my God. And I got it on my lashes, sweet. LA Girl actually liked my photo the other day. Hi, LA Girl, I see you. Holy bejeebus, this is full coverage if I ever seen it. So with that primer, I'm still seeing my pores quite a bit, but that might just be because I have so much product on right now. Now I'm gonna go under the eye first off with the purple. Then blending underneath with the reddish pink. And finally further down with that yellow. So basically just following what we did on the top, on the bottom, but without the shimmer. I don't know if you can see this. I think it's the primer that's doing this, but you can really see my pores. Like, the foundation isn't going into them. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Stay Matte by Rimmel. I typically go for a translucent powder. This is a pressed powder, so that's the only reason I don't touch it. A tinty bit under the eye.
Yeah, I tend to prefer a loose powder just because I can bake with it. For contouring, I don't actually contour much, but I felt like doing it today. I actually haven't found a contouring product that I absolutely love yet. That's probably because I haven't splurged on one. I have the Glamazon Face of Australia contour kit. I don't really use the highlighter just because it's a little bit, oh, it's all right. It's just not as like bright as I would want it to be. And I found the contour color was a little bit patchy. Now, I don't contour much, so I don't know how this is gonna go. I don't like when it has the half and half. I feel like I can't coat my brush evenly. It's not too bad, it's just a little bit harsh and then it doesn't blend out. To top it off, I'm gonna go in with another color that I don't think is right for me. This is the Dream Sun Maybelline Dream Sun Bronze. Yeah, it looks like I've used it a lot. This is because I dug some out to mix with a lotion to make like a shimmering body. It just fell out of the thing. And it just smashed on my ground. Oh my God. That didn't go as planned. Anyway, I used this product to like smash up and put in lotion anyway as like a shimmering body whip kind of thing. So I'm not really mad about the fact that I just smashed it. I used it once on my face and I thought it was way too orange. And it also has shimmer in it, which I really don't like for bronzers. But it's literally all over my floor right now. Oh well. Anyway, I'm still using it even though it's smashed. On the face, this one's just a little bit too snooky for my liking. Gonna put a little bit down the sides of my nose.
I always spray before I highlight. So this one I use all the time for skincare. It's the Mario Badescu facial spray, just the original one. But I never use it for a setting spray, so I wanted to try it out. I mean, it doesn't have glycerin or any of the stuff that would actually set your face, so I don't think it would really do anything except for make your powder look a little bit less cakey. That one's not drugstore though, but still pretty cheap. Maybe not cheap because it's like rose water and it's $17, but the only highlighter that I don't really grab is this Models Prefer Holo Glow highlighter. They look white, but then they come out. That one has like a purpley blue reflect. I think I'm gonna use the purpley one. Only reason I don't grab these is because like you don't really want to wear the purple holo highlighter for every day, but they're actually really, really pretty. I'm gonna mix the middle one and the pink one and just highlight. They're actually really pigmented. I'm actually really living for the holo highlight. I'm looking glowy. On a little lower mesh, just putting on a little lower lash mascara, just using that Nude by Nature one again. Finally, for a lippy, I'm gonna go in with the Maybelline Seductress. The only reason I don't wear this is because I don't usually go for liquid lipsticks, just because I find them a bit drying. I think this one's gonna match this look quite well though, so I'm just gonna. I feel like I didn't wear this because it was too nude for me when I bought it, but now it is absolutely perfect. Like, I might even wear this tomorrow. It hasn't dried down to a complete matte yet, so I feel like there is a chance it could come off, but maybe I just need to give it a little bit more time. I feel like you can get a much more defined lip as well with a liquid lip instead, so I might actually start using that one more because I really enjoy that color. It made it really easy for me to overline my lips, if you can see. One more spray with Mario Badescu. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the finished look. So that's the completed look of full face of products that I never use, and I am so happy I did this video. I feel like I found so many things that I would have never grabbed before that I'm actually going to start using every day. For example, this Nude by Nature mascara, I absolutely love it, and I'm for sure going to be using that. Believe it or not, I am loving the L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Matte Foundation, and it actually matches me now, which I wouldn't have found out if I didn't do this video. There was lots of things in there that like I would have never dreamed of using, and I actually love the way it turned out. I recommend for anybody who's like a makeup lover like me to do this, because you'll probably end up finding some really good stuff. I wanted to say thank you again for all the new subscribers and all the views and all the love, and I love you so much, and thank you, and mwah. So now I'm gonna take some photos because I look
bomb.
If you haven't already, please subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like down below. Follow me on Instagram at SusieJTodd and Twitter, which I recently got, at SusieJTodd as well. Thanks guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Mwah.
Bah.
I made a few mistakes, I regret it nightly. I broke a couple hearts and I wear on my sleeve. My mama always said, girl, you're troubling.